Why and how important is it that they broke out these segments now?
I thought it was a real nice positive that they did that. Look, they missed numbers. That explains the trade-off. The stock should trade off when that happens. I think you're going to sustain most of the year-to-date gains because you've got accelerated share buybacks, because the revenue growth is largely intact. Don't tell anybody this, but they've gone 10 years in a row of 20% plus organic revenue growth. No other company except for Amazon has done that in financial history. And then this new disclosure that they've given you, it turns out that search revenue is growing stronger than almost everybody thought. I think the market sentiment would have been that search is like a low double-digit growth business, 10, 11, 12, 13%. It turns out it's growing high teens, especially if you adjust for currency. That's a positive. The growth rates for YouTube is largely as expected. The revenue is a little bit smaller, but the growth rate's more important. That's largely as expected. And cloud is growing very close to Azure level. So I thought what they told you about the growth of the different segments, I thought that was actually a big bullish takeaway. That and the share repurchases make us more positive, where the still negative area is those margins. And it doesn't seem like this company is really going to try to manage for margin stabilization. That's a negative, but the other things offset that.
Mark Shmulik, I could make an argument that it would have been better if the search results had not been as good and cloud and YouTube were stronger. I mean, that's the future. You kind of want to see a company show high competence in more than one trick and see the growth rates on a smaller business, an underdog in cloud, being much higher than Azure and AWS. Why is that wrong?
Yeah, I think, you know, where we are today is search is still a significant part of that core business, right? It's a majority of their revenues. It's going to maintain to be a majority of those revenues with a really nice margin profile attached to it. And so exactly what Mark was saying is, as you see a really kind of solid growth in that core, that should give investors a lot of confidence going forward. Totally understand that you do want to see some of those new areas grow, and I think we were slightly disappointed with where YouTube came out, and that just showing to be a tougher business than people expected. But we still very much like that core story. Google's still about search. Search still has a long way to go in terms of how we're using it today versus is how we'll use it in the future.
Mark Mahaney, the disclosures we got in terms of Google Cloud and YouTube ad revenue, was it enough for you? Or do you feel like a big piece of the picture is still missing since we didn't get profits, we didn't get some of those breakdowns, for example, the revenue sharing within YouTube?
Yeah, that's a great question. I think they need to provide a little bit of view into the profitability of those two segments, cloud and YouTube. We can just look at comps like what AWS did in terms of its historical profit growth profile over the last 5 years. So chances are a good thing for Google shareholders is that Google Cloud should be at a scale level where it's no longer margin dilutive based on what AWS has disclosed in the past. But we're just guessing there. Google, tell us the real numbers, so help us out there. And then just put things in context. Google Cloud is going well, but, you know, look, there's a clear winner in cloud computing. AWS added more revenue this last year than Microsoft Azure and Google Cloud combined, or just about the same amount. There's no real evidence here that Google Cloud's gaining share, but they can grow in line with the market. YouTube, I think it's just got a great growth profile going forward. There's a lot of, it's still under monetized. It's really still the future of television for most people on this planet. So I think it's a great asset. Google is handling it well.
Mark Shmulik, any clarity yet on the Sundar Pichai era? I mean, he's been at Google for a long time, but now over Alphabet. Is it just a coincidence, you think, that they gave these metrics in his first earnings call with this much power? Did they do it maybe because the results are weak, or because he really does want to be more transparent or challenges these businesses to grow?
I think it's all the above, actually. I think there's, you know, cloud was expected. They've made a lot of announcements around that. They want to be a serious player in cloud. They want to be top two. And if you want to do that, and with Azure and AWS closing, you kind of have to do the same thing. YouTube was a bit of a surprise, but the one thing that we're noticing a lot with the Sundar era right now is he's really going after this wall breaking across the different product teams. And so we're seeing that play out with some of the new deals that they've announced with cloud. So Activision, for example, it's almost this quid pro quo-like model where you bring Azure, you know, you bring the infrastructure for Activision on the back end, and in exchange, YouTube will become the streaming provider for the esports platform. So they're doing a lot of these cross-platform.
What was your guess on YouTube's number?
So we had it about maybe 20% higher than where they came in. I think we were expecting a little bit more traction on the direct response side, but what we're really seeing, it's still very much a brand advertising platform, and there you've just got a lot of competition. You've seen Super Bowl ad pricing increase and remain high. You see a lot of the kind of cord-cutting, connected TV growing in that space, and you even got Twitter still playing a pretty strong role in kind of monetizing their users.
Did you hear anything between the lines that they would commit to buying big pieces of media rights the way we've talked about for years?
Yeah, I don't have a great sense of that. I think they've constantly kind of dabbled in it. We've seen a little bit on the gaming side. That seems to be where they're making some of their more recent strategic bets. You know, you see this battle kind of emerging for, you know, user-generated content talent, and I think we're going to see much more there. And so if there's one disclosure I'd love to see is what they're paying for the talent.
Yeah. Mark Mahaney, I just want to go back to this idea of the emerging Pachai era here. Google's other revenue, the fact that it was arguably a little weaker than expected, disappointing. How would you expect that strategy within that segment to play out? And given the fact that Pachai is now taking the reins of the overall company, do you think that there are changes that are made there?
I wouldn't expect any dramatic changes there. And if you look at that other segment, so there's hardware in there and there's cloud. Cloud was largely as expected, good growth rate. It's the right place for Google to be. That hardware gets a little lumpy. In what investors need to know is that in 2018, the company did a series of launches. Oh, no, they jammed all their launches into that fourth quarter. That created a tough comp for Google hardware this year in 19, where they'd had launches throughout the year. So that's kind of a small little optical issue. I think that hardware business is still good. The pieces together all looked, I think, relatively attractive. And I thought the YouTube disclosure to say that $3 billion of that YouTube revenue, so it turns out it's like $18, $19 billion in total YouTube revenue, $3 billion in subscription revenue. This is a company with very diverse revenue streams. That's what you want as an investor. That's what you want as a holder in Google. And they're giving it to you.